And when you do the math, when our planet needs to support 2 billion more people in the next 3 decades, it's not hard to figure out that this is the time for a second green revolution. That's why Dr. Sanjaya Rajaram is being honored now with the World Food Prize. And we're grateful for the hundreds of new species of wheat that Dr. Rajaram has developed.
Wheat is the most widely grown cereal grain in history. It was the first crop to be cultivated by humans in the Fertile Crescent, where people discovered they could bake it into bread. Today, wheat is the staple food for 40% of the world's population and continues to be the most important food grain source for humans. The 2014 World Food Prize Laureate Award Ceremony is historic. Although World Food Prize founder Dr. Norman Borlaug spent his entire life working to improve wheat, the prize has never before honored another wheat scientist. Tonight, it is most fitting as we culminate the Borlaug Centennial Year and look ahead to the future that we honor a man who has done more than any other person since Norman Borlaug to improve and enhance wheat production. Sanjaya Rajaram was born to a farming family in 1943 near the small village of Raipur in northeast India. At a time when 96% of the rural population had no formal education, young Sanjaya attended primary and secondary schools in a village 5 kilometers away from home, where he was ranked first in his class and won a scholarship to high school. He went on to earn a bachelor's degree in agriculture at the University of Gorakhpur. Growing up in a small village where people had very little, Rajaram had experienced hunger all around him. It instilled in him a deep desire to use his education to make a direct impact on food production, a motivation he would carry for the rest of his life. It led Rajaram to study genetics and plant breeding under Dr. M.S. Swaminathan at the Indian Agricultural Research Institute in New Delhi, graduating with his master's degree in 1964. A scholarship from the Rotary Club of Narabri gave Rajaram a special opportunity to earn a PhD in plant breeding at the University of Sydney in Australia. It would change the course of his life. It was there that his mentor, Dr. I.A. Watson, recommended Rajaram to Dr. Borlaug at the International Maize and Wheat Improvement Center in Mexico, commonly known by its Spanish acronym as CIMMET. This set in motion Rajaram's career in wheat research. He would go on to build upon and extend Borlaug's legacy, raising it to an entirely new level. Rajaram worked side by side with Borlaug in the experimental fields of El Batán, Toluca, and Ciudad Obregón. Borlaug was so impressed with his work that in 1972, he asked Rajaram to take his place as head of the wheat breeding team at CIMMET. It was during the following year that Rajaram began his own innovations, experimenting with crossbreeding winter and spring wheat varieties.
Raj took another dimension, has never mentioned it, but that's how I interpret it. He crossed winter wheat with spring wheat. It revolutionized wheat production in Pakistan. You serve the world with a target in mind. Empty stomachs, you've got a problem.
Rajaram extended Borlaug's shuttle breeding approach into countries beyond Mexico, growing 2 successive wheat plantings each year in different latitudes. This approach cut in half the years required for research, and the variation in climates resulted in much more adaptable wheat plants. Rajaram was also able to foresee diseases that had the potential to threaten crops on a global scale. Through his concept of slow rusting, Rajaram and his team at CIMMET were able to develop wheat strains with resistance to rusts, the most damaging diseases affecting wheat worldwide, thus protecting the world's food supply. Rajaram realized the importance of freely sharing knowledge to help developing countries produce more food. He began expanding the Global Scientific Wheat Network, a worldwide exchange of genetic resources, information, and innovations among wheat researchers. Like Borlaug, Rajaram's goal has always been to take real-world solutions directly to the farmer and ensure that they are accessible.
I learned from Raj very early on, if your products don't end up in the field and they are not distributed and adapted and your partners don't accept it, you really have not contributed much.
After a distinguished career at CIMMYT, Dr. Rajaram joined the International Center for Agricultural Research in the dry areas and later developed his own seed company, Resource Seeds International. Because of Rajaram's dedication, today wheat is even more accessible to the world's smallholder farmers and the poor. Sanjaya Rajaram was at the forefront of the golden years of wheat breeding and production, perhaps the greatest period of wheat production in history. He was able to identify the most desirable plant varieties for crossbreeding, creating new high-yielding wheat varieties that were disease and stress resistant and adaptable to diverse climates. The impact of his life is enormous. During his distinguished career, Rajaram developed 480 high-yielding disease and stress-resistant wheat varieties that have been grown on 58 million hectares in 51 countries, increasing total global wheat production by more than 200 million tons. As a result, he has been recognized with numerous awards. And in 2007, Norman Borlaug praised Rajaram as being the greatest present-day wheat scientist in the world, calling him a scientist of great vision. It is therefore most fitting that tonight, as we conclude the Borlaug centennial year, we celebrate and honor a man who was born in India, spent his career in Mexico, and has made an impact on farmers worldwide. A man who has inspired a new generation of wheat researchers. A man whose exceptional breakthrough achievements in improving wheat have provided more bread for a hungry world. The 2014 World Food Prize laureate, Dr. Sanjaya Rajaram.